interested in exercising and sending that because everybody is counting on you as you conclude this exercise. I wish you all the best in the days today. Thank you very much. Probably I should have mentioned that because once more, we have our great team coming together here, the great team of moderators, and you know how they did very good work yesterday. I want to introduce them to you, Dr. John Sayimba from the Department of Mathematics, Dr. Forrest Waika from the Department of Linguistics and English Language Statistics.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome again to this exercise of listening and to presentations by candidates who wish to take offices in the offices of the Deputy Vice Chancellors, both Academic Affairs and Finance and Administration. Today we are going to listen to the candidates who wish to take this university on in the office of the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Finance and Administration. The first session will be handled by Dr. Chitanyiwa and I will come later.
Good morning to you, ladies and gentlemen, and you're all most welcome. We have been told that at exactly 9 o'clock we shall kick off, and we're starting off with Professor William Bazeyo. Professor William Bazeyo is a Ugandan, a professor of occupational medicine. He was born in Uganda in 1957. He's married with 3 children. He graduated with an MBCHP in 1985 from Makerere University. Thereafter, he obtained a Master of Medicine in Occupational Medicine from the National University of Singapore in 1992. And he went on to obtain a PhD in Public Health from the Atlanta International University in the US in 2014. He has been a head of department, been a deputy dean, and he served as dean for 8 years of the School of Public Health. He's currently the acting deputy vice chancellor of finance and administration, and he has served in this position for the last 1 year. He joined the Makerere University way back in 1993 as a lecturer, and has since risen through the ranks, the academic ranks, to his current level of professor. He has attended several professional development courses, including authentic leadership development at Harvard Business School in August 2015. He has attended strategic planning and management courses at the Boston University, health insurance and financing at the University of the Philippines, and several others. He's been a principal investigator for several projects that have been funded by development partners, including USAID, CDC, DRS, and many more. He's the PI of the Resilient African Network that brings together 20 African universities in 16 countries, and that project is worth $25 billion. He's a PI of the Center for Tobacco Control in Africa, a project worth $11.8 billion. He's a peer of the One Health Central and East Africa, funded by USAID, a project worth $12.5 US. A PI of the Monitoring and Evaluation Technical Support, and it is a project worth $32 million. Members, he's been a PI for several projects, and when you look at the total funding he has won, it comes to about $106 million US in the last 10 years. For academic citizenry, he has published more than 50 peer-reviewed articles in journals, and he supervised over 40 students at 2020 level to completion. He has established linkages with partners from the US, from Africa, and Asia. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome with me, Professor William Bazeyo. Professor, you have 30 minutes to address us, and thereafter we shall engage you with very interesting questions. Thank you.
Moderator, such committee, chair and the team, the chair of council and the vice chancellor, management, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, moderator, for those kind words. And I hope they made me feel good. I have put some relevant bio because they said 30 minutes, so everything is cut into half. But I'm going to say you just multiply by two. So I finished my candidate in DVC-F&A, I did my master's in Singapore, and my PhD in Atlantic International University. I have held several positions in this university, but I'm only put the academic ones and one academic and leadership. I was head of department, was deputy dean, and I was the dean of the School of Public Health. Just to let you know that I was very influential in getting the School of Public Health autonomy from the Faculty of Medicine. I have won several awards. And the latest one was on Saturday, where I was selected as the winner for the regional training and research for East Africa, which I think is a pride to Makerere, having had Kenya, Uganda, Rwanda, and Tanzania all vetting them from South Africa. I have presented here only the relevant qualifications and trainings that are relevant for this position. But I have done several of them, and those ones are on my CV. I did an authentic leadership development course at Harvard, and I know that in this university, only two people of us have done this course. I did strategic planning program at the Boston. I did health insurance and health financing. This is very, very important because it touches the health insurance of this university, which I think I'll talk about and make you see how bad it is. I did international trade and international dispute resolution, where we covered negotiations. I did medical practice and contemporary labor issues. When we're talking about labor, I am well conversant. And remember, I did educational medicine, which deals with workers. People at work. I did grants writing course funded by CDC. That's why the moderator was saying he won this, he won this. So we have been trained how to write these proposals. And I believe I can bring this back to the population in the material. I did planning and management information system, HRs, and then international environmental management. International environmental management, that's where we talk about where we are. Looking at our environment, campus environment, and what we have, trees, plantations, and so on. Now, before I say the challenges of what affects Makerere, I want to say, and I want you to reflect as I present, what am I bringing that is relevant to those issues? One, the management table, I want to bring Prof. professional, I'm a professional manager with tested leadership skills. I have the ability to mobilize institutional resources, and I'm a mobilizer. A negotiator who negotiates until I get a yes. If I get a yes, I get strong. I will see where I got a yes. 7 years of university leadership and regional and international network leadership experience. Research, grant making, as the moderator said, small and big. My smallest grant was $6,000 for the whole year. My biggest grant now is $34 million a year. So small and big, I am there. Human resource capacity problem. I led the school from the coming, from institute to coming school, those of you who are senators, and I developed the capacity of the school. At the time I left, we had nearly 3/4 of our staff with PhDs and wanted beyond simulation. I have experience with university systems. Now, what are the strengths that I see in Makerere that we can build on as we make Makerere better? One, we have 9 vibrant colleges and 1 independent school. When I was checking many universities that have colleges, actually started with 2 colleges. For us, we have 9, which we can actually grow and become like 9 universities. We have the vast number of students. We have the largest number of students in the region. In the region. Therefore, we should take advantage of that. We have the human capacity. Source of when we produce human capacity for other universities. So if we can produce to others, why not for ourselves? We have a good brand name. In the decision coming from that our name, Makerere University, is more known than Uganda when we were doing the benchmark. So that means we can actually champion ourselves. We account for 70-85% of the research that affects this country. And therefore, we can work on that and get more resources to do more research for this country. We are grateful both locally and internationally. That was in the discussion of what. The other strengths are we have a strong HR capacity. We have the largest number of PhDs in the region, in Makerere, and professors. I was looking at Chapel, our brothers. They have less than 5 professors. And we are saying we are competing with them. We are not. We actually need to match them. We have to provide staff. When you look at our support staff, many of our support staff actually have masters. That's why at times we need to go back to the establishment where people are required to have 1 degree. Now, when they have masters, we say they are qualified. I think we need to change some of that so that we reign with the center. We have these courses. I have checked. Makerere University has the largest amount of land as a public institution in this country. And we must take advantage of that. The infrastructure, the indoor stadium that we have now, nobody has it, and then the facilities. We have estates. Estates should be developed. How to lead this town, this city. We have good, we both domestic, I have talked about that. We have a wide network of well-placed alumni. It is a little bit. When you go to any country, you'll find a Makerere graduate. Why don't you take advantage of those graduates to do this? The financial challenges. Now, the university has so many challenges, and I have grouped them. One is financial. We have limited diversification of resources. Our revenue base is still small. We still depend on knowledge and intuition. We have student tuition, which is not even unit cost. But you cannot do unit cost in the economy of Uganda. So we must find ways to have students, sustain them, they study, they don't drop out, but we also still make money. College budgets are unable to meet many of the best corporations. You are giving your professors, these budgets don't meet what you need. We need to do something. Failure to implement the strategy and work plan. Is because the resources are not adequate. We have increased increasing university aid again, and an conducive teaching, learning, and research, programming, and there are. All these are challenges, but they are challenges that project around finance. The human resource challenges include underfunded and understaffed. We say we understaffed, that's true. And therefore, people end up doing a lot of work, which is not remunerated. So we must find ways of raising resources and remunerate that work, not ask for small money and we say that this is an allowance. The allowance is not sufficient. Lack of appraisal and performance in the world system. This university, we need to appraise people and reward them as a way of motivation. It is done in many other universities, it has not been done. We have an unmotivated staff, including myself. The salaries we are paying are low. We need additional resources, Mr. Vice Chancellor. We need to look for resources to make us demotivated. For example, you have so many students, 300 students, and you have no time to go and look for money elsewhere. So why do you get common good or incentive? So we must find resources to address what was incentive or common good by the school. And it's not a demand for material alone. Many universities do this, and how they do it, I'll come to tell you. Because of restricted recruitment policies, McKinley has challenges in talent identification. Even if you have a great student, first class, you cannot retain him because you can't employ him. There is a ceiling. Recruitment is against a budget that you cannot expand. Then we have limited overlap of medical health services for staff. When we talk of health insurance, does McKinley University have health insurance? My answer is no. When I started health insurance, every university has a health plan. We need to have a health insurance for ourselves and our dependents. When we come to administration, there is limited interaction, engagement, and conservative approaches. Where does management meet all of us? We need to create opportunities for us to meet, discuss, and see what hurts us. Inadequate support systems for staff. People are employed. You go to estates, they are there, they are many. And they do not know what they are supposed to do because they have not been skilled to that. People are given jobs. We have business, we have aims. Now, people are saying we can't register. The registrars are saying we can't register because there is no plan to redo and make people move forward. The last one on the administrative, which is more touching to many of us, is security for students, staff, and property, including that. We all know that students are bad, are robbed, they are raped. But I'll tell you what we have done and what we continue to do. The other challenge is, I prefer to put other challenges as that, although they are not other. They are also very important. Students. The students, on the student side, have the poor learning, living, and social environment. Poor facilities for ICT. Imagine a university student, post-graduate, that has not had internet around his room, his class. The only internet that is in classes and in the compound that I know in Makere is in the School of Public Health. But we can present that and expand the whole of the university. The environment generally and conducive for teaching, office space is small. I have visited some and the people share for laboratory and so on. Colleges are not yet in real sense colleges. We need to decentralize so that colleges are empowered to perform. The schools and the departments need to perform their duties. Dissertation, rollout, recycle, we can write proposals. But we do not have that negotiation to do what? To get the clarity course. Now, proposed solutions. We need to put the university on the path of financial sustainability. Build long-term financial sustainability. Empower the estates, the elite, So these are the farm, these are the people that we need to exploit. And the holding company, the university farms, why should the company be there? You don't make money from there. Come on, you should feed this city. Feed this city. Financial, we have to propose financial, want to get strong linkages with the public and the private, so that our interns and the other people find research. And then we want to negotiate with the government to give us loans, because money is not going anywhere. If they gave us a loan and we built, we will suddenly pay, because we make money from them. Administrative, we want to strengthen the credits, as I said. Qualities must be strengthened. And when you look down on the robots, security, council and management realized that security was a big problem. So through our research and survey, we found the dark hiding zones. So, and included plantations. So it was decided to cut them and clean up and make the place. And we have done that. Ladies and gentlemen, since we did that, how many cases of rape or bugs being snatched have we had in Makere? Zero. Human resource, we want to improve the human resource capacity, we want to build the appraisal system. But what's one important thing I want to say? And if you go out from here, go with this. Makere University has not had this kind of skill. What we have as a silent skill from government is actually a guy that your government can afford. So we need to establish a silent skill from a like others is, and we're able to look for resources and talk about Professor Big with 15 million is denied. Other suggestions want to organize resources for supporting the unable students. Imagine the best university in this region, we have no single scholarship for our students. We need to raise resources and find the unable but bright students and they come into Makere. And we need to create student employment. Our students are not employed, that's why they are out there. But if we engage them, give them what to do in the leisure time, and we pay them. But we cannot pay them if we have resources. We need to streamline admissions. We say admissions, people are taking them. Where are they taking? They are taking because we are being late. So we need to be strategic that we hurry and do a rolling admission. When somebody doesn't come, we replace. Now, this slide I have to discuss, it needs a strong point. The challenges that the university faces are common. All of us know them. The possible solutions are what we do well fair known. In any case, there is and what I believe is what is great. One most important issue there is identifying the candidate with the pedigree, resource mobilization skills, and determination to turn this idea into reality. This is what I think we need at this point. And I propose to establish, once again, this job, to establish a desk that will monitor. Possible sources of funding, all of these are known, and I am not going through all of them one by one. But the last one, we need to establish a donors forum. Where you have people that commit themselves, I will fund Makere within $1 million every year, no matter what comes. We have the people who are winning. They are businessmen. Some of them are alumni. Some of them help Makere and they say, I want to associate myself with Makere. Naming our assets. Ladies and gentlemen, how can you have a building for 90 years? Its name is called main building. Main building. When there are people that are there and can give us more than 100 million or 50 million and we put their name in smaller acres. So we need a voice around that. Programs. We need to review the programs with the intention to develop our research edge and graduate foundation. And then we need to, I talked about the colleges, and then we need to do the not ordinance, I'm not going to talk about what is going to happen because we are in the bid. The first bids have come, we are opening them and evaluating them. Talking about them, I think, is not true. Talk about what we are bid for all of other places. Research grants, these are my achievements, and some of them were mentioned by the moderator. But look, when I came into the school, we had 40 projects. I left when we had 114 projects.
See this graph?
That's. When I came into the school, our turnover per year was 8.9. I left when our turnover was $38.5 million a year. I was able to secure a monitoring, an environmental monitoring instrument that is owned by me. Only in Uganda they use that in the embassy, but we got one through my embassy. We monitor the air in the whole of Kampala up to the airport. That's the emergency. That's the only machine that is around in the whole of the country for an institution. Very important. This is the infrastructure that I'm talking about. This is School of Public Health infrastructure that I was able to create, and I think we could do that. All those at the School of Public Health, some of you have never been there, you can go and see. These are the innovations that we were able to support with my project that they talked about. And those are the people who work with me. We need to establish the University of Science and Technology Park, STI. Science, Technology, Innovation Park. I'll tell you that because of time, I'm not going to verify it, but when you know what the park does. Now, see where the parks are. Uganda is nowhere. And we are competing with these countries. And the nation must be in Makerere University. Those are some of the things that we plan to put in the science park. Now, when I say plan, these drawings are actually being drawn to one of these. I'm working with private partners so that an appropriate time, whether I am in this office or not, I bring it to mind that we're able to actualize them. And that's what we think that we should be able to get. Now, as I have come towards the end, as DVC, acting DVC, what have I achieved? I told you I negotiated up to yes. We negotiated with the Minister of Education and Finance for Makerere University Retirement Benefit Scheme, which has always been a pin, a nail in our debts. We got 20 billion, 10 billion last financial year, 10 billion for the next financial year, and last week, only last week, we got an extra 5.1 billion. And I don't know whether the US wants to tell me that there's more that we need. If you do, we shall still negotiate it. There was a shortfall that was going to happen, and some of you would have been worrying that you had a budget we were paid. I negotiated for 4.5 billion because of the shortfall that was coming on our salaries now, and I got it. I negotiated for money for the stadium. If some of you were there, I became the person who is installing the building, I don't know. And I was there all the time. We got 5.7 billion and we put up the structure. Now, NIC has always been a problem with Makerere University, fighting and not paying us. Now I negotiated with NIC, and only a few days ago, we finished the deal. With the building on Kampala Road. Makerere University will have a building on Kampala Road too. I'll show you the photo. I was also last week negotiating. You know, students, everything is available. I negotiated with the government and we got 1.5 billion. The US, I told you, start to consolidate. I negotiated with people to advertise on campus 150 million by year for 5 years. Food rights and internet that must be there for students. And then we also negotiated last week the in-house For those who have already worked, we have now got 9.8 million. This is money for them. Now, most of you know that Makere has always had a problem with mobs. As I tell you, mobs, we have no more ramps now. Zero death to mobs, zero death to Makere. And I'm sure the chair of council will officially announce it when they meet. We have no more problems with mobs as far as money is concerned. They have paid what they owe us, and we have zero. Clear negotiation in front of the minister. I have also negotiated, and this one I didn't want to tell you, but I saw that you keep it. I've negotiated money reinvested for Makere University for research. They have never given us money. It took 2 days to explain like the concept which they threw out, another one modified it, and the DC is aware that we have been allocated in the next budget, 2019-2020. 15 billion for the first time for research. It is coming as a presidential initiative for research only. That's our baby on Tambara Road. It is occupied on the top floor by BRAC, and it is on Tambara Road and Nkrumah Road. Now, in conclusion, this side of the I want to repeat it. I bring management as a professional manager, I come as a professional manager, tested leadership skills. Ability to mobilize resources, to mobilize and negotiate until I get a yes. 17 years of university leadership and regional and international network leadership. Research grants, skills, capacity, capability for human resource development. And lastly, experience with the embassy systems. A contribution to Makere University recovery. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Professor William Bazeyo, for such a wonderful presentation. And now it is our time to engage Professor Bazeyo with questions. We shall take 3 at a time. I will say yesterday, do not explain the questions. Just ask the questions. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much, Professor Lazeo, for that presentation. As staff members, we've always been treated to information that all that money, it's good you say you're going to get more money, but we've been treated to information in the press that money is wasted, and that's the whole reason we cannot pay common good, and as a result, the sort is granted. So, when you become DVC-F&A, how will you ensure that all those monies you're bringing are protected from waste and staff get motivated? We need common good.
Thank you very much, Professor Bazeyo and Professor Sabi. You talked about the lack of a system to reward staff who excel. You realize, Mr. DC, there was a document, I was a chair of the Act of Committee of Senate. We developed a document to reward all Makere staff now and in the past. Senate approved it. I was sorry to went to council. We have never got any feedback. There is a big document, it took us time to develop. So when you have the opportunity, please follow up that document. Thank you.
So that it is renovated and kept clean to show us to the world. Because last week, 2 weeks, we had a geopolitics conference that it is, as you can see, is in a sorry state, and what picture did they take? So we need to know what you're going to do to make sure that this place of material is kept up to standard, so that when somebody comes here and says, yes, this is material, we want to hear proof from that.
Thank you so much, Professor Bazeyo, for the presentation. My name is Paul Muyinga. Professor, one of the causes of strikes at Makerere University is actually tuition fees. And in our neighboring country, Kenya, there is no student who drops out of the university as a result of school fees, because of all students can access government loans, whether in private or public university. And as a good negotiator, what plans do you have to ensure that all students that qualify to join Makerere can join on, say, government bursary?
With this money. And with the introduction of business, So there will be no waste. I can show you the systems in place. Lastly, the strike is an issue. In my presentation, I said, imagine McKinley with no scholarships. You know, you quoted Kenya. Kenya, the presidential editing said, everybody will get a scholarship. The economy is stronger than ours. Uganda, we may not be able to reach there. But I will not promise you that I want to negotiate with the government to get more funding or more scholarships. I propose that we raise resources and create our own university loan scheme so that students who qualify are ours, we admit them, we give them loans, and because of the AIM system, which is linked to the national ID, we are able to track you. And for you to pay the money, we must create opportunities for you to be employed by bringing on board the private sector, the banks, so that we work with them, we do internship there, they employ you, we know where you work, you are able to pay. But our students now have been coming, they started and go. We don't know where they are going to work. We must create opportunities for them. Thank you very much.
We shall take another round of questions. Three questions. This time I'm going to go to the back.
Thank you, Prof, for your presentation. I'm just wondering about the 50 billion that you negotiated. Is it only for finances or is it for all of us? Thank you, Professor, for your presentation on the site on the Great Macquarie Road to Recovery. My name is Mr. Tumhechi, and my question is in regard to the evening program. Recent research has established that the evening program, the administration of the evening program at this great institution is lacking. We admit these students and we seem to have lost the purpose for which the program was established. The students have more or less turned into cash cows to bring in money for the institution when actually they don't receive back value for their money. So my question to you, Professor, is what do you intend to do ensure that the students of the evening program can benefit well in terms of the services they receive so that they can actually accomplish their learning objectives?
We shall go there. Can you take that one? Go there next.
Thank you, Professor. My name is Davidson. Thank you for your presentation. My question relates to the security of the university properties. And we understand, I'm a journalist, so I've been following up some of these things, especially relating to the issue of university land. And I think that is your pocket. Majority of the land currently has issues, and we have had several people situated on that land. And the university has struggled to even recover that. And what is your mission to make sure that university regains back its land and it does those development projects that like you're suggesting? And relatedly, the university.
And I know that I have had some people have approached the land. colleagues will support you in the ministry of defense and internal affairs to make sure that you get your land. So when we came back, my office put up a task force, which includes our staff from the internal security, Ministry of Defense, and lands. And I can tell you that, as I said, that we have the biggest or the largest amount of land. Most of our land is not encumbered. Two, that had some issues, the task force is working on them. And many of the people that we found on our land have actually accepted that we are material land. Can we negotiate with you? And that's why money comes in, to negotiate, and then I get, yes. Even programs. Now, when even programs started, I think they started with the School of Law. Some people have misunderstood them. Both the public, students, and others. Who are the people doing evening classes? I don't know whether all of us know. When I went to the admissions, in the past, evening classes were supposed to cater for those who are able to come to school during the day and are working. But it turned out that evening classes admit those students who are unable to meet the cutoff point for the day, for the morning. Therefore, we have many students admitted from A level evening, although they have no jobs. So the best thing they can do, they have nothing to do at home. They come and live around the campus. Now, I say something about student employment center. These are the people that we should actually employ to do work like registration and other things. And we shall find them. Then they go to class and they do. But coming back to work for money, I talked about the morale and the motivation of the staff. If you're quite paid and you can't raise even food for your people, most likely you're going to register. You can raise some money for food. But if we are raising resources to motivate, incentivize, give the common good, people will be well paid. People will do research. Let me tell you, if you are doing your research and you have money, you are well paid. Of them in speech. So they get their value for money when we put things in the right system so that people are well paid, motivated, and then we shall also use them to do work and we give them money. Also, they need the money to do other things. Lastly, I think that was reading class in the security. Then they someone has to talk to research. Madam, research is research. When I go to negotiate, I don't go as a scientist. I go as Bazeyo, DVC, Finance and Administration. How is this money going to be used? Maybe just give you a good start to start planning. We are not going to get the 50 million and say, cover 10, choose 20. No. Because we have teams that have trained in writing what they call RFS, request for application, where they find a topic. For example, I want to ask you, does anybody know why Uganda coffee sells $8 to $9 a kilo and Uganda coffee sells $1 to $2 when they open them in the market? So this is a study that you can do. You write an RFS, you apply, you are here for it, they evade your application, they allocate you the resources. So whether you're in arts or science, you won't benefit. The other money in that research, we are looking at science. People have no money in their science labs. They are paying for money for research and buy equipment for their research. Therefore, we shall have equipment for the labs and also do research that involves this nation. Thank you very much.
Thank you, moderator. And I wish to congratulate Professor Bazeyo on his presentation. My name is David Bartling. I'm from the School of Law. You talked about retirees at Makerere University and the benefit scheme, but there is a group perhaps including paying interest on delayed payments. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor, for that elaborate presentation. I'm Patrick Manini from the School of Liberal Performing Arts, and I want to address specifically the matter of the Center of Performing Arts, which here we go with the theaters that are quite important in the cultural life of a number of universities. Currently, and since the university, the Central University, we have not had that facility. How might you approach that matter?
Thank you, Professor Bazeyo. My name is you talked about mobilization of resources, and you also talked about the one man thinking that the other one has money all the time. I don't think we can develop or base on being all the time. Among others, we have to demonstrate ourselves by doing something by ourselves. I'm requesting to hear from you what you intend to do about utilizing the potential that we have, mobilizing funds from us. The staff of university, administrative, academic, students, and the like. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I'm certainly the Center for Performing Arts. A month ago, I represented McKay University at the inauguration of the President of Harvard, the only two universities represented from Africa, UCT and McKay University. The other man was a white, so I was a black. So there was only one black university represented. But what did I see? There was a function that was led by the performing act. They said, all the performers, that center was paid $1.8 million. How did I know? I went to see the head when he talked and finished. I went to see him. Well, they performed so much. Then I wanted to know where he went, the people with the poems and so on. And he said, this center makes more money and many centers here, because we do work, we perform in all over this city and all over this country in the US. Now, for you, you do not have those resources. We must give you a target. Because you have people, you have been to weddings. You see people, they bring in this performing people, they pay you. McKinley University, we are there in attendance. We have our people, we have our students that we can actually develop and use and make resources and make that center. That's the center that needs to develop, including another center that I didn't talk about. We don't have a museum here. People go to universities to go and look at a museum, and they pay. You have seen these buses going around with toys. When they come here, they just really sit and so on and they go away. We have not started with the resources for them. We will start, but we must have something for them to see. Begging, we cannot beg forever. I say, we have the resources that we must exploit. Our land, our buildings, our students, ourselves. I talked about government engagement. Every other day, you see an advert that the government wants to do this study. They give people who are paying McKay. If we had organized funds in McKay, would they be getting that money? Or if we negotiated with government and we signed MOUs that Obama's, quality of health services, anything to do with health, they will be contacted. I must tell you, my dean is here. I negotiated with Global Fund and the Ministry of Health. That anything they want to do, the first thing is school public health. If we are unable to advertise, if we are able, we don't need it. We send an MOU and they are saying that why did you say it? You are going to call us, you want to pay the law. Why? You should be audited. Because when you get the resources, I don't find it. Lastly, Professor Wachidim, you know, when you are coming from nowhere, you can't ask for everything. The money I talked about for retirement benefits scheme, we didn't go there once. I went there, they gave there. I came back, I said this for yours. They gave us another thing. And I told you last week, I went back. And I presented the case and I went back for the toilet, the toilets, and the remaining 3.1. And then I said, but how about in-house? They said, okay, we shall also be. So even the US, I think you have had, the graduate should be paid, should actually be paid, including me, because my appointment has expired, has been on contract. I should also be paid. But on the interest speech, I think as an entrepreneur and a loving environment driving person, if you have been an institution, you love it, it's served you, you serve it. If there is great money, and you know that they didn't have, when they did it, we will request you to accept it without interest. Because we cannot ask where we are getting, that give us interest. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Professor. And finally, I'm going to ask the final question. Professor, the presentation has been lovely, but there are some buzzwords now around the university. Things like research aid, and then thinking about finance and our 35,000 students. The university, instead of being a research aid university, which ended up being a teaching aid university, so because these are the major funders of this university. As a person who negotiates until a yes is given, where do you see the position of Makerere University? Given what you have talked about, Shambo, Sitema, they are also teaching now, they are teaching BCO, they are teaching BBA, and we are competing for the same students. Makerere University, more than 95 years since its establishment. What should be its position as a research university in this country? Thank you.
Thank you very much, moderator. You know, you said we are competing with the same universities. I think foundation students. If we are competing, then we are doing the wrong thing. Students should know the only place they want to go is Makerere University. So Makerere University, we must strategize ourselves. And I talked about this. None of these universities, when you hear KIU that they give for laptops and so on, but they give that knowledge. I was on the Council for Victoria and I left. And a ceremony, I said, this is not where I belong. I went there and hoping that I would help them come here and again. I saw they were going away. Sorry. But when we say science or research, really, in many universities, ladies and gentlemen, researchers have students on their projects. Makerere University, we do not have our students on our projects. There must be a change of mindset. How do we consider our students? These are the work and the work we do and the research we do. So we must integrate them. But why are we not integrating them? Because we have not had the negotiation power to say, you are funding me, but I have students who will do research. So we have been dancing around the donor saying I am funding only this. So we must change, and we cannot change it when we have our own money. Come the 50 million, we will have our students to research with us. And our students and prospective students will know.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in appreciating Professor William Bazeyo. We are going to have